Welcome to this week's 2-Minute Tip Tuesday. My name is Val Madsen from the Respite Care Association of Wisconsin, and this week's topic is functions of behavior and what they might be communicating. We've all interacted with individuals that might be acting out or having a challenging behavior, but sometimes we don't step back and think about the reasons why they're acting out or why it's challenging. We have to remember that, yes, it's challenging for us, but it's also challenging for them. So oftentimes we have to think about how we can support that individual so that they can get whatever they need. Usually if there's a acting out behavior or a challenging moment, they are communicating something that they need. It's an unmet need that they have, and we have to figure it out. One way to do that is to look at the functions of behavior. And really, there's typically behavior can be divided into three categories. The first is to gain access to someone or something. So maybe the individual needs attention or needs something done for them. They're hungry, they're thirsty, they're sleepy, they need something. And so they're trying to gain access to whatever that they need. The second function of behavior is to avoid something or someone. So this might be someone who throws something because they don't like it, or that they really struggle going into some place, and so they sit down outside the door because there's something in there that is not okay for them. And so that's how they're communicating that behavior. The third thing to think about is sometimes the function is actually a sensory or medical or diagnosis issue. If you have someone that has some medical needs or sensory issues, maybe it's not something they can control. If someone who has diabetes, if they have really low blood sugar, they might be acting out or having a challenging moment, but it's because of the blood sugar being low. Or maybe there's a sensory issue and the lights are too bright, or there's that little noise they can hear that maybe we don't recognize. So we need to figure out the function of behavior so that we're able to best support the individual that we are working with. So hope you enjoyed this week's 2-Minute Tip Tuesday, and we'll talk to you again soon.